right tackle, the left guard, and to Jamal Charles to take the edge off of him. And it's amazing what teams have done because of the production. They get 55 and a half sacks in his last 52 games.
It's first and 10 for Devontae Freeman. He didn't crush it. Also hit on the play by Max Bowler, just called off the practice squad. No gain on the play. So the Atlanta Falcons have gotten two long touchdown runs by Freeman, one of 16, one of 23. The Houston Texans have added five times, three punts, two turnovers, interception, and fumble.
Well, you know, it's always important to win the battle in the trenches. And to me right now, I think the Falcons are winning the battle up front offensively. They're doing a great job attacking down the middle of this defense. And they're doing a really nice job cutting off the backside, making it difficult for Watt and Clowney to make plays on the edge.
Looks over the middle, second down and 10. Freeman. And up front for first in the center. Motion down and back here by 9. The play for Freeman. They'll spot him at the 26.
You talk about the zone run scheme. Everybody's trying to get angles. They do a great job on the backside, cutting off. Look at the backside. Center guard, they're all getting up on the second level, getting hats on those linebackers and safeties. And Freeman, he's just looking for a gap. He's a guy that wants to bounce runs to the edge, but he's gotten a lot better at being more patient, staying on his course, and hitting that upside.
That last tackle, third down and 2.
J.J. Watt. These defensive ends, Kevin, they hate that. They hate when guys go down at their legs. You have to change up a player like J.J. Watt. We just showed you teams double him, to triple him, then you cut him. Team up with the